What will happen to your bank accounts if something happened to you? I'm attorney Vernita Williams. In these unprecedented times, I'm being asked a lot of questions about last will and testament, revocable trust, bank accounts, power of attorney, and I just decided to do this video and talk specifically about bank accounts. There are 8 specific things that I recommend that you take a look at. I did write them in my computer, and I just want to tell you what they are right quick before I talk specifically about bank accounts. The 8 things are: number 1, the living trust; number 2, medical power of attorney; 3, durable power of attorney; 4, last will and testament; 5, revocable trust; 6, joint tenancy deed; 7, Totten trust; and 8, insurance considerations. Now, you might not need all of these, but most people will need at least 4 or 5 of these. So in this video, I want to narrow down to the bank account. You need to make your bank accounts where they are easily accessible. If your family members need to help you, it's very, very challenging if they can't get to the bank account. If you were to pass away, it's very, very hard if the money is in the bank only under your name. So I want to talk specifically about the Totten Trust. There's something called a Totten Trust, and you probably know what it is, but you probably don't call it a Totten Trust. It is that simple pay-on-death card or form that you fill out at the bank when you open a bank account. It is very, very good for you to list a beneficiary on a bank account. And also, it's a good idea for you to have another person on the bank account that can transact business on that account without you. I want to talk about the Totten Trust, though, that pay-on-death card. You do need to list beneficiaries for your bank accounts. You can go to the bank, and if you haven't already done it, list a beneficiary. It's better for your bank account to have a beneficiary than not to have one. Because if you were to pass away and that account doesn't have a beneficiary, your relatives are going to have to go to probate court to try to get the funds out of the bank. And once it goes to probate court, everybody's going to take a stab at trying to get that money. You're going to have to pay the lawyer out of the money. There may be some creditors you're going to have to pay. But even if you have creditors, if you have put a beneficiary on that bank account, that money is not going to go to creditors. So if you don't have a beneficiary on your bank account, you need to do that yesterday. So list your beneficiary on your bank accounts. Now, one of the things that I've noticed over the years is sometimes people will put one person as the beneficiary for a bank account with instructions to that one person to share the money with 3 or 4 or 5 other people. And guess what? A lot of times that just doesn't happen. The one person gets the money and they take it and they don't share. So if at all possible, if you got other people that you want to receive money from a bank account, why don't you just list them as a beneficiary and let them go and get their own money? That's the best way to make sure all these other people that you might want to receive money from a particular bank account can receive the money. So make sure you position your bank account so that that bank account does not end up being a probate asset in a probate case simply because you didn't name a beneficiary for the account or you didn't place anybody else on the account that can transact business on it in your absence. So that's just my little tip about bank accounts. If you'd like to call me and strategize about how to set your affairs in order, I'm happy to do that. Please text me or call me at 786-831-9483. That's 786-831-9483. Thank you so much for listening.